Hello, everyone, and welcome to Medford Anywhere Learning TV. We're glad you're tuned in. We want to give a shout out to our friends at Southern Oregon PBS, KTVL, KDRV, and the Dove Network. Thank you for hosting us on your station. In the Medford School District, we have one shared vision, and that we believe that all are learning, and learning is for all. And what better place to do that than right here on Medford Anywhere Learning TV.
Hi, I'm Kathy Pauk. I teach PE at Howard Elementary School, and today we're going to do a easy, medium, hard workout, and we're making our own PE equipment, some bean bags. This is my friend Clara Aranda. She's going to be interpreting for our Spanish speakers today. And this is my daughter Kylie, who's also going to be helping and playing with us.
Hola, yo soy Clara y esa es la señora Kathy. Ella enseña la educación física en la Howard Elementary. Ella enseña el kinder hasta el sexto grado. Y esa es su hija Kylie, que nos va a ayudar ahora. Y ahora vamos a hacer unos ejercicios difíciles, medianos o fáciles. Y ahora también vamos a enseñarles cómo hacer las bolsas de frijoles para que puedan hacer actividades en sus casas.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone. I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down, it'll all be clear. Don't pay no mind to the demons, they fill you with fear. The trouble it might drag you down.
Oh,
are going to get started making some PE equipment at home. And in our class, we play a lot with bean bags. So I figured we could make some bean bags with things that we have at home. I have three socks. They're kind of medium height. They're not too short and not too long. We have a half cup or 1/3 cup, just so it's all one size, no different sizes of measuring devices. And I'm going to be using rice for my bean bags, so I guess they're rice bags. So what we're going to do is fill the rice in the measuring cup. I'm going to take this sock and put it around the measuring cup. That way it doesn't get spilled. Then dump the rice inside the sock. Now I'm going to give this sock to Kylie, and Kylie's going to tie a knot at the top of where the rice is. Go ahead, Kylie, and I will do the next ones. What do you think about these rice bean bags, Kylie?
I think that it's super fun, and you can play rice bean bags anywhere.
Yeah, sure can. Here's another one, Kylie, for you to tie a knot in the top. And we'll do this at the end. This is what it looks like. Got my last one. We're going to be making three bean bags today. Take the sock and put it over the measuring cup and then dump it all in. Hand it to your trusty assistant at home. Kylie's my daughter, so she's in my home. She's going to be helping. Now, if you want to, when you get done, you can fold this over, and it actually kind of looks like a ball now. So it's kind of like a ball that has beans in it or rice in it. So it's really handy. Great. Just like what we use in PE. All right. So you get your bean bags ready or rice bags ready, and then we're going to play some games.
Hola. Hoy vamos a fabricar equipos para educación física. Usamos bolsas de frijoles o puffs mucho, así que lo vamos a hacer hoy. Los materiales que tenemos aquí son tres calcetines medianos o largos y que sean de tela delgada. Necesitamos tres porciones iguales de arroz o frijol, lo que ustedes tengan. La cantidad de cada porción tiene que ser media, un tercio o un cuarto de taza o lo que hayan escogido. Acuérdense que las tres porciones deben de tener la misma cantidad. Ahora, pon una porción en cada calcetín. Abre bien la parte de arriba y echa ahí el frijol o el arroz. Hazlo con cuidado, metiendo la taza lo más adentro posible. La volteas para que caiga hasta el fondo el frijol o el arroz y luego, con cuidado, sacas tu mano y la taza del calcetín. Ya que hayas hecho lo mismo con los otros dos calcetines, trata de hacer un nudo al calcetín en la parte de arriba. Luego, ve doblando el calcetín desde arriba para que parezca como una pelota. Así que ahora tenemos puffs en casa. Ya te mostraremos algunos juegos que puedes jugar con tus puffs.
Okay, now that we have our PE equipment, the bean bags that we made, we're going to play a fun balancing game. You're going to put your bean bag on your head, and then we're going to make a big mess. Kylie, can you bring the toys and make a big mess on the floor like you used to do when you were little? Oops. Nice. And then we'll put the bucket where we keep our toys over here, and we're going to try to pick up our toys without the bean bag falling off of our head.
Ahora vamos a jugar un juego de desafío con las bolsitas de frijol. Lo que vamos a hacer es jugar un juego llamado ordenar. Vamos a tirar un montón de juguetes en el piso y luego vamos a mantener las bolsitas de frijol en nuestra cabeza y daremos vueltas y tratamos de recoger los juguetes.
Oh, no.
Si nuestra bolsa de frijol se cae, entonces haremos tres flexiones.
Oops, put my bean bag on my head. Tidy up the house. Do we have all the toys picked up? One more.
Almost.
Don't drop it, Kylie. Yay, we tied it up. Good balance, everybody. So the next thing we're going to do is a little bit harder, and it's a skill called juggling. And juggling takes a lot of practice. Normally, you toss the ball from hand to hand, and you watch it go into your hand.
Lo siguiente que vamos a practicar es un poco más difícil, y sobre todo, este es para niños más grandes. Pero si se te hace difícil, entonces sigues practicando, porque es hora que tu cerebro se desarrolle. Vamos a hacer algunos malabarismos.
So now we're going to toss it up in the air, kind of like a rainbow, and we're going to watch in front of us and see it in front of us as we toss it from hand to hand. And again, this is really hard, and it's okay if you drop it. There's going to be a lot of drops when you learn to juggle.
Vamos a practicar tirando la bolsa de una mano a la otra. Es algo así como haciendo un arco iris alto y delgado. Mantenga las palmas de las manos hacia el techo y trate de ver cuándo esta bolsa de frijol llega a la cima. Esto es difícil porque no estamos viendo la bolsa de frijoles caer en nuestra otra mano. Lo estamos viendo aquí arriba. Y te ayudará si no lo avientas un poco más alto para que te da más tiempo para capturarla. Y está bien si se te cae porque se nos va a caer mucho las bolsas de frijol.
Now, after you have that down, you can get two of your bean bags. Kylie's using oranges. I don't recommend you use tennis balls because they're pretty bouncy. Use something that always the same and is not too bouncy. When we add a second one, I'm going to toss this one in the air. And when this one's at its highest point, then I'm going to toss this one in the air over to the other hand. And I'm kind of going to be tossing them under like this.
Ahora vamos a tener dos bolsitas de frijol. Y cuando esta llega a su punto más alto, vamos a aventar la otra. Combina la segunda bolsa tan alto como la primera. Y la segunda bolsa estará un poco debajo de la primera. Y trata de aventarlas más o menos a la misma altura.
When you have that down, and that is really hard, that's really great if you have that down. If you have two down, then you can add a third. You're going to put the third bean bag in your dominant hand. That would be your right hand if you're right-handed, and your left if you're left. And you're going to hold the first one between your thumb and forefinger, and the second one in your palm. And of course, your third one's the other one's over in this hand.
Ahora necesitarás tres bolsas de frijol. Vas a tomar dos en una mano, las dos van a estar en tu mano dominante y la otra bolsa de frijol en la otra mano. Y vas a tirar esta primero, va a estar entre tu pulgar y índice y la otra en tu mano, tu palma. Vas a tirar esa primero y entonces la otra y entonces esa.
So we're going to toss this one first, the one that's in our thumb. Toss this one when it's at its highest point, then you toss this one. When this one's at its highest point, then you toss the third one. And a good way to do this is just practicing by letting them fall on the ground in the order that you toss them. So you go one, two, and then the one in your palm, let them toss on the ground. One, two, three.
Primero los vas a dejar caer al suelo para que puedas saber los movimientos primero.
Oh, sorry, Clara. And after you practice it a bit, you can practice tossing them and then just catching the three. One, two, three.
Después que ya sabes los movimientos, ya puedes tratar de capturar todas.
Remember, it's okay to drop it. You're going to drop a lot.
Y acuérdense que es bien si se te caen, porque se van a caer bien mucho, también cuando lo estás haciendo por la primera vez.
After you can toss all three, then you can see if you can do it 4, 5, or 6 times. Every time it's at the top, then you toss the one from the other hand, and you just keep going back and forth, tossing them like this. That was 4. 5.
Cuando ya puedes capturar todas, vas a tratar de ser de tirarlas 3, 4, 5 veces.
6. And then you could just see how many you can do in a row. And you might even be walking forward while you're doing it or walking backwards. It takes a lot of practice.
Si tienes que caminar siguiendo las bolsitas de frijol, está bien si tienes que hacer eso.
Kylie broke her orange, and I think she's afraid to keep juggling with it. So I don't know if you should be juggling with your parents' fruit or not. It's better to make your own bean bags.
Pensamos que es más mejor si usas bolsitas de frijol o pelotas que no brincan tanto, porque si usas las frutas se te va a pasar que pasó con Kylie y se quebró la naranja.
And Kylie and I have been doing juggling for a little while. Clara is new and she's been practicing at her house. So we're going to have Clara practice to show you that it's kind of hard when you're first starting out. I'm going to put them right here and then Clara can get them and we can stay safe and far apart from each other.
La señora Hawk y su hija Kylie, ellas han hecho eso por muchos años, pero yo apenas empecé hace 2 días. So, así que yo no sé cómo hacer eso muy bien, pero voy a tratar.
1, 2, yay! Good job, Clara. You did it. And now we're going to have Ben from Southern Oregon PBS try his hand at juggling.
Oh.
Yay!
Oh, he's got it.
Good job, Ben.
Amazing. Estupendo.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Woo, look at me go.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone. 'Cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down, it'll all be clear. Don't pay no mind to the demons, they fill you with fear. The trouble it might drag you down. Know you're not alone.
I'm gonna make this place yours.
Thanks for tuning in to Medford Anywhere Learning TV. Medford School District is a place where all are learning, and learning is for all.
So nice to meet you too, Dr. Jampian. And yes, I have a couple of questions. This one's quite serious.
All right.
So, from one champion to another, who are you going to root for?
Well, what are my options?
South Medford Panthers, North Tornadoes.
Whatever team is representing Medford, I guarantee that's the team that I'm going to be rooting for sure.
If you got to make a holiday, what would it be?
Make a holiday? I think I would go with Color Day. Late January, when it's real dark and cold outside, we have our holiday, which is Color Day. And on Color Day, everybody wears their bright colors, like your bright pink. All the cakes are multicolored cakes, and there's confetti and things going up in rainbows, and you name it, there's color everywhere. And we take the gray world and we make it colorful. How's that sound?
Good.
It's pretty good. Thanks.
What state are you from?
I grew up and spent most of my life in Texas. I was born in a small town right in the center of Texas. I started teaching at an elementary school in Houston, Texas. And I taught elementary theater arts for a number of years in the Austin area.
Have you been on Pottermore before?
Have I been on what?
Pottermore.
What is that?
It's a Harry Potter app.
Yes.
So you can take quizzes on it and, like, what's your Patronus and... Yes. What's your house?
What's your Patronus?
It's a type of dog. I think it's a terrier.
That's so awesome. I'm afraid I'd get on there and be like, my Patronus would be like a chipmunk or something. I mean, I want something ferocious and incredible. I mean, I'm nervous to do this whole Potter, what's it called?
Pottermore.
That's awesome. What house are you?
Hufflepuff.
All right, Hufflepuff, that's awesome. I've always appreciated Hufflepuff.
Other countries, such as Finland, they have technology classes such as coding and computing. Do you think our school district could have the budget to implement those kinds of classes in schools?
Great question. As a matter of fact, it's something that the Medford School District has prioritized over the last few years. We've got, for example, the Chromebook rollout that's happened starting this year with ninth grade, which offers an opportunity for a tool for our students and teachers to be able to access technology very easily, literally in their hands. However, we know that coding is a skill that can grow, and it's definitely something that we are considering looking toward for the future. My son happens to be a computer programmer, and so this is very near and dear to my heart as well, so that's a great question.
What is your favorite type of car?
My favorite type of car is one that runs, that has an air conditioner, and that's pretty much it. Also, like good gas mileage. Get me there safely, and have an air conditioner.
What's the first change you want to propose as superintendent, and why?
One of the things that I believe, John, is that it's important that there's not this idea that I'm going to bring all this whole new set of ideas into the system. That actually what we need to do is together, with teachers and with principals and with students and with all of us, the board, coming together and saying, here's who we want to be, here's where we want to go, and then let's talk about then how we get there. So this idea that I'm some sort of magician who has all the tricks to make all those things happen. That's not the way it works. What happens is we together have the best ideas together. And so one of the pieces that I want to bring is to make sure that we're doing that, that we're bringing the voices of teachers and students and principals, central office folks, and the community together so that we can make some things better.
Hello and welcome. I am Mrs. Herbst, and it is my honor to be the principal of Central Medford High School. Here at Central, you will find that not only do we have an amazing teaching and support staff, all of them have made a commitment to fostering an environment of respect, building positive relationships, and connecting academics to real-life experiences and skills. Whether you have always believed that you will graduate high school, or if you may have ever felt that it is impossible, I am here to personally guarantee that if you stick with our school program and follow the expectations we set forth for you, you will be a high school graduate and have opportunities laid out for you to become successful in life after high school. Here at Central Medford High School, we are a family. We are all here to support you and work together to overcome any obstacles that you may face to your success and the goal of graduating high school. We are asking you today to join us on a journey of discovery. We are asking that you make a commitment to be part of our school program as we learn together as part of a discovery program. So what is this discovery journey all about? I'm so glad you asked. For the next 6 weeks, you'll be working with your teacher to develop a strong sense of community and establish positive support systems for yourself. You will learn, practice, and provide feedback on important positive skills needed for you to be successful in school and in life. And we will all be working together to reinforce the culture of our school and ensure that all of us realize what is expected of each other, what we expect from students, and what you can expect from faculty and staff. For you to graduate from our Discovery program and go on and work towards graduation from CMHS, you'll be expected to follow the foundations of the Discovery program, otherwise known as the 6 P's. They are prompt, be to class on time and be here every day. Be prepared. We want you available for learning and ready to receive what the teacher is instructing. Always be polite. Always come with a positive mental attitude. And participate in the activities and the instruction that we have set forth. And finally, produce. Show evidence of your learning. Along with the 6 P's, you will learn many more awesome skills that will support you in your success in school and in life, such as attending skills, working in effective groups, anger management, communication skills, assertiveness training, problem solving, and conflict resolution. At the end of each one of these units, you will have an assessment to show that you're proficient in each one of these skills to move towards graduation of the Discovery program and move on to graduation from Central Medford High School. Don't worry though, all the work that you do within the Discovery program has credits that you'll be earning along the way. We just ask that you show up and participate, and we'll support you in the rest. Also, please know that we're going to have a lot of fun. There's going to be celebrations and activities along the way that we're excited to bring forward and work together to bring a positive school culture and help you in skills, not only to be successful in school, but also life after high school. Take a moment and read our mission statement and look through the vision document that your teachers provided for you. Again, it is my pleasure to welcome you to Central Medford High School. We are all here to support you, and we are so happy you're here.